Hello everyone, I am Sanjeev and I am here to provide a demo on code review tool. Before moving to the demo on the code review tool, we should know what is the use of this tool, what is the objective of this tool and why we need this tool. So objective of this tool is to make code clean, correct and useful. The code should be in a such a way that each of the developer can understand what the objective of this code is. Systematic way to evaluate quality of process used to produce a quality product. So if we are making any code, there should be a proper naming convention. We should not have hard coded anything. If yes, it should be properly written in such a way that every developer can read it. Predicts and prevents the occurrence of issues, bugs or defects in the application of the product. Provide high level walkthrough over the code. So suppose if I am a business user, I don't have the knowledge on the tool. So how I can walk through over the code? We can export into the Excel and we can send them and they can check it that okay, if the formula that we have applied is correct or not. Save a lot of time of developer as well as reviewer by identifying the issues. So how we do the development is first of all developer do the code and then reviewer reviews all the code step by step. It's a time consuming process. So if we are going to review each of the code, obviously it will take time. How we can reduce the time? Once the developer develops the code, reviewer just check it over through like in the previous point I mentioned, walkthrough over the code. So walkthrough over the code will be helpful for the reviewer in this step. Again, it's a single platform for code validation of various tools like Informatica Cloud, PowerCenter, MuleSoft, etc. So we don't need to go to a different sets of rule for a different tool. This will be a single tool where all the not all the, but there will be few tools which can be checked in. So what is the need of this tool? You see there are two screenshots that has been attached. So and the left hand side you can see the naming that M underscore INC underscore FF underscore. It's not a proper naming convention. Does it convey any information? No. Similarly, other jobs are also having the same same kind of name, which is not having a proper naming convention. On the right hand side, this is a screenshot of a code which developer builds. So they have written source 1. What is source? Can we get a rough idea that to which system it is pointing? What this source is used for? What expression is doing? What is the target? What application it is? So this screenshot shows that, you know, proper naming convention hasn't been followed. So this tool will address all those questions that we have raised in these slides, how we can solve it. So how easy is the tool to use it? When you see the tool is working very in a simple way, you need to export the code. Once the code is exported, you need to upload the code and the code validation tool gives you all the details of the code. If it has followed proper naming convention or not. And if you go to 360 review, it will provide you the rules that you have implemented. It will provide you the formula that you have implemented. It will provide you the transformation you have implemented. What are the source? What are the targets? What are the naming conventions that you have followed? Everything will be appearing in 360 review. So 360 review can be used by a business owner or a reviewer, which can review the code and walk through over the code. So it's just a simple process, three step thing: export the code, upload the code, get the details. Simple. What are the functionality that we have added to the tool? So first functionality, that is rules. It will work as a repository for all the rules that needs to be validated. So we need to predefine the rule, which are the set of rules. So suppose if there is a mapping and we want it to start from map underscore. So with this rules will be showing you that, okay, for mapping, the name should start with map underscore. For mapping configuration, it should start with mct underscore. Next is code validation. In the previous slides, we have shown you how we can implement the logic. So code validation is once after you upload the code, it will validate the code that have you followed the proper naming convention. If a connection name is not starting with CON and you have defined a rule that it should start with CON, obviously it will throw an error or it will display on the page that the naming convention isn't properly followed. Next is 360 review. 360 review is very powerful functionality of this tool. So what it is like, once you upload the code and you ask the tool for the 360 review, it will give you the all the naming of the codes. If you have used any pre-session, post-session commands, if you have some configuration settings, if you have used any transformation, then what is the name of the transformation, what logic you have used, which type of source you are using, are you using a Salesforce or ServiceNow or Flexera or any kind of source that you are using. So it will tell you that which source you are using. This way it will let you validate that which all components you have used. Reviewer can check that have you used a proper formula. Suppose you want to use a formula, you have used a formula for the average, 360 review directly shows you which formula you have applied without going into the code. So in this way, business users which don't have that much knowledge on the tool can also validate it, because it's very easy to read on the screen or on the Excel sheet, rather than going onto the cloud, rather than going onto the code and checking into all those things. So these are the functionalities that have been implemented in the tool. Now let's move to the demo of the tool. So this is code review tool we are talking about. You see here rules. It is having Informatica Cloud naming conventions. If there is some configuration level settings, if PowerCenter naming convention, Informatica PowerCenter configuration, MuleSoft validation. So we need to define it. We need to predefine the rules on the basis of which code validation will be working. So when I click on here, it is saying mapping should start with MAP underscore. It depends on org to org, means few companies prefer some different names and few of the companies prefer some different names. So we can change it, but we need to define the rule as of now on the basis of which the code validation will be done. There is again Informatica Cloud some folder. Folder should start with CAI or CDI, stop on error, what is stop on error, session log file name, have we defined session log file name. All these are the rules that should be defined, and those rules will be checked in code validation phase. Concerning to code validation, as we have already discussed in our previous slides, that is very easy to use. We need to just upload the code here and then it will provide the output. So before uploading the code, we need to export the code from Informatica Cloud. So let's export the code from Informatica Cloud. This is one of the org I'm exporting. This is process. This is mapping. So mapping will come under data integration. Process will be coming under application integration. So this tool is having extra advantage of other tools, like if there are tools in market, so they can either read CDI jobs or CAI jobs, that is cloud data integration jobs or cloud application integration jobs. Here we are adding a functionality where you don't need to look into it if it's a CAI or CDI. You just blindly export it, which all code you need it. I'm exporting the code here. So code is exported. Let us check as I'm downloading it here. And once the code is downloaded, only thing is we need to click it here, choose the file which we need to check it, open it, upload. And you see here all the things, like there was map. I told you that MAP underscore FF, MAP hyphen FF hyphen INCR hyphen FF is the mapping. Then this is the process. So it is checking each of the things. It is showing that this is the expression. It should start with exp or exp underscore, but the name that is expression, similar to filter, similar to name. These are the things that transformation, it is saying that the transformation or variable that you have used is not correct. So this is the output name is not proper. You have given output variable name as name, but it should start with out underscore. Same with process also. So it is saying that TMP underscore it should start with, but it is not. In this way, it will tell you that which all code are not following the proper naming conventions. Then there is a 360 review. 360 review is more detailed one which can provide you and walk through over the code. So I'm uploading the same code here also. Upload it. And you can see it here what it is providing. That mapping name is map underscore this one details hyphen connection name is detail. So these are the connection names that which are have been there. These are the process name, mapping details. If we have used a variable or any functions here, these are saying you what we have used it. And then there will be coming for process details, which if you have used any function or anything, all these things are coming in detail view. And we have added a functionality for exporting all those things. So once we export it, everything will be exported into an Excel, and we can just directly attach it and send it to business user, maybe reviewer, anybody who can, and then we can show them that this is how it looks. This is a mapping one, this is a process detail, this is all these things. We can just directly send them and they can verify it. So for people who are not expertised on Informatica Cloud or any other tool, it is very easy them to, you know, read the Excel, find the formula, and if they are okay with it, then we can go ahead with it. This is all we have implemented in phase one. Later we will be implementing various steps in phase two and phase three, which will be covered in the slides. So what are the advantages of this tool over the other tools? This tool will be providing a single platform of code validation of many development tools, be it IICS earlier, which was known as Informatica Cloud and ICRT, Informatica Power Center, DataStage. It will not only provide the error message, but also provide a 360 review, which is the most powerful, I would say. Also, it has a repository for all the rules, so you don't need to go here and there to check all the rules that needs to be done, implemented. It's very easy to use. It's just export and import logic needs to be done, and it's all yours. It also provides information about the transformation logic used, target properties, session properties. It has the functionality to downloading all the details from the 360 view page, like how I have shown you, that you can download into Excel sheet and directly you can drop an email with attachment as Excel sheet to the business user or to the reviewer. So what are the roadmap of this tool? So when you say phase one was validation of predefined rules, exporting functionality for 360 review, code review functionality, all these things has been done. Phase second is comparison of code, providing flexibility to change the rule. So it will be like project wise, or you need to, there will be administrator which can change the rule according to their own. Addition of some more insight like showing percentage of proper coding, version history, all these things needs to be added into phase 2. Phase 3 will be implementing data dictionary. Again, it's very powerful thing. Down the line, we will be needing the data dictionary, that how data is flowing from source to target and which all logic has been done. Including the same for other tools like MuleSoft, Talon, etc. Next is, can you get a trial account or demo? Yeah, sure. So if you need a demo, you can just drop an email with info-codeinsight@moitech.com, and a representative from our team will be contacting you for providing a demo on this tool. If you want the trial version also, we need to follow the basic steps. You need to consolidate all the rules that needs to be implemented along with the tool name. Is it Power Center? Is it Informatica Cloud? Is it DataStage? And down the line, we'll be implementing for MuleSoft and Talent. You can mention that also. Then you need to send an email to info-codeinsight@moitech.com with the details mentioned in the first step, and all will be created and the details will be shared with you on this. Feedback are always welcome. If you have any feedback, any suggestion, just drop an email to the same mail ID. So that's it from our side. Please feel free for any trial account or demo, or if you have any suggestion or feedback, it will be really helpful. Thank you. Thank you for your time.